Dear students, we have started work on Microsoft Access and we have created tables, forms, and today we will go to create reports. So, to create reports, we have different options. We can create reports directly or using wizard, and then we can create some of the formatting. So, why we want to create reports? In fact, at the end of the day, you want a report that could be created for your particular software, that what was the profit you have made, what was the loss you have made, or for example, we are interested, or someone is interested to identify that how many students are there who have qualified to be qualified in one of the subject or not. So such kind of queries could be performed, and the results of those queries could be generated in the form of report, and then that data can be printed directly using printer. So let's start the practical. So we have these three tables as we had already. So for example, if I click on this table and we go into create and then report. So we have one option that we can create report like this. So as soon as I clicked on it, so you can see that a report has been generated that has all of the records in it and the name of the table, from where this report has been generated, the date and time, right? And at the bottom, it's a total. So first of all, you need to save this report. So report underscore TBL220. So module name is invalid. Okay, we need to add it like this. It's not taking hyphen. So we have report available over here. So if we go into the design view, we can see that this is the report. And I can change whatever I want over here. So for example, I can see that this is the personal record management report, right? Or maybe we can just go with this one. Then of course, all of the formatting can be applied as well, right? So for example, I'm saying that I need such kind of color, and the data should be bold, right? And then this ID should be named as student ID, code, etc. And this is count of all of the permission which is available. So after making changes, if we click on this report, so you can see that this has significantly changed. You can also add different other things. So for example, here you can add other related things like themes, colors. You can also change the fonts. You can also add different toolbars. In the controls, you can go as we did in the last module. We can create images. So for example, if I am interested to add image over here, so I have added. And then there are other options like logo, which we missed in the last module of form. So here is the logo which can be added to the report as well as in the form as well. So for example, if I click on it, and I can select any picture available, so that would be placed over here. And then I can also put the title, so which is over here, and other related things like date and time if I'm interested. So I have added date and time, so that is available over here. So if I click on this, so this is a very interesting report available. So this was one of the way, and the next way is you go over here, create, and then report using report wizard. So here I am interested to see just this field and this field, that's it. And then I am interested to see this as a descending order. So let's see what happens. So this is another report that has been generated, and this report contains only the marks of English in a descending order. So all of the students have been sorted based on the descending order of the marks which are available over here. So all such information can be accessed in this report. So this is a way of representing your data and making your data more comprehensive and coherent to represent. So dear students, let's conclude today's module. We have learned that how we can generate reports, and we have also seen that logos and date and time and other information on header and footer can be inserted in the report, and similarly that information can be inserted in the forms as well.